We begin tonight with claims that a first grader was handcuffed and shackled by a recovery school district security guard.
His parents say that their six-year-old son is now traumatized and he's afraid to go to school. It's tonight's Big Local Story.
Our children are not animals, and they should not be treated this way.
Education. The Weston family says their six-year-old son was abused while in school at Sarah T. Reed Elementary.
My six-year-old child was handcuffed and shackled to a chair by his school.
The parents say the boy, who's only being identified as J.W., had an altercation with another small student in the cafeteria. And when a staff member stepped in...
But a security guard apparently intervened and took him off to the principal's office where he was handcuffed and shackled. In addition, they learned at that time that he had been handcuffed 2 days prior in the in-school suspension room.
The family was even more shocked after meeting with the principal.
And this was further confirmed when the principal clearly stated that it was her policy to handcuff and shackle kids who failed to comply with school rules.
Now a federal lawsuit has been filed over the allegation.
When you handcuff and shackle a child to a chair, to a piece of furniture, I can think of no other analogy other than what happens to animals. And even then, we treat our animals better than we treat the kids of New Orleans. I think that's a shame.
Now the Weston family is worried about the impact that this may have on their first grade son.
My son is afraid of school. He fears the security guard.
Instead of working with us and our son, they handcuffed and shackled him. And now my son is scared forever. Thank you.
The recovery school district says it has investigated the allegation. They found it to be true, but it says it was an isolated incident and it is not district policy to handcuff students. By the way, the two security guards involved were both fired.